If you clicked on this video, you've probably heard the phrase, gravity is not a force. I think I've even said it a few times. But I'm starting to wonder if we should stop saying it. Hey crazies, we've been saying gravity is not a force for a long time. And there's a good reason we started saying it. Like, I understand how we got here. All the way back in the mid-1600s, there was this guy named Isaac Newton. He gave us three laws of motion, a law of gravity, a form of calculus, and the beginning of wave optics. All of which we still use today. Newton was a big deal. We know. Okay, here's why it matters. You know those three laws of motion? Well, the first two establish the major types of behavior, inertial and non-inertial. A book sitting on a table and a rock floating through empty space are both examples of inertial motion. Basically, anything traveling in a straight line at a steady speed, even if that speed is zero. Everything else is non-inertial. A car inside a traffic circle, a rocket accelerating into space, the orbits of planets and moons, a squirrel falling from a tree. All of them are non-inertial, according to Newton's laws. What does this have to do with forces? Forces are what separate the two types. For the rock floating through space, there are no forces at all. The book sitting on a table does have a couple forces, but they balance out and cancel each other. There are no net or total forces. Those situations obey Newton's first law of motion. It says, in the absence of a net external force, meaning that if you add up all the forces from outside the object, you should get zero. These other non-inertial situations require Newton's second law of motion. If you add up all those forces and you get a non-zero value, then the object will accelerate, meaning it will change speed, change direction, or both. You still haven't told us what a force is. Yeah, that part's kind of tricky. The simplest definition is any influence from one object onto another. That includes pushing, pulling, sliding, buoyancy, and as far as Newton was concerned, gravity. I mean, why else would things be drawn to each other in space if not by a force? It's a perfectly reasonable conclusion to come to. And we didn't question it either. At least not until Albert Einstein and David Hilbert published their papers on general relativity in 1915. According to their model, gravity isn't a force at all, it's just inertia. Planetary orbits like these are just inertial motion. This is actually steady speed in a straight line. Those straight lines just look curved because they're in a curved space-time. We can't trust our eyes anymore. The same reasoning applies to this squirrel falling in a vacuum chamber. There aren't any forces here drawing the squirrel to the floor. It's just following an inertial path. This idea also changed how we looked at situations we thought were obviously inertial. Remember that book sitting on a table? If there's no gravity here, then there's only one force, the upward push from the table, making it non-inertial behavior. What? Yeah, it's crazy, but experiments have shown this model to be accurate. It works! And this is how we got here. This is why we say gravity is not a force. But here's the thing. A force is any influence exerted from one object onto another, right? If a star changes straight paths into apparently curved ones, is that not still an influence? Does the indirectness of it exclude it from the definition? I'm not sure it does. The not-so-obvious problem here is that we're working with two different definitions of force. The one that feels right to non-physicists, and the one that physics has extrapolated from Newton's laws. They were equivalent until Einstein and Hilbert came along with their curved space-time. So now physicists use this second definition and say gravity isn't a force. Everyone else uses the first definition and argues the opposite. I'm right, physics is wrong. Calm down, bucko. I wanted to see if I could reconcile this issue without a fight, so I did some digging. Actually, I did a lot of digging. Newton's Mathematical Principles of Natural Philosophy, or the Principia for short, was published all the way back in 1687. The word force does appear in the English translations, but never in the original Klingon. I mean Latin. That's right, he wrote this monstrosity in Latin. The word force actually comes from the Latin fortis, meaning strong, mighty, or brave. you know, like fortify. So it shouldn't be that surprising that its first use was in a military context. Anyway, fortis does appear in Newton's book a couple of times to mean strong, and not to mean what we would later call a force in physics. The word Newton used for force was vis, which usually means energy or power. But force kind of works in this context, which was a good enough argument for academics when they started discussing his work in English. And as you can see here, he was likely responsible for its more widespread use. Stop dilly-dallying and get to the point. I actually found a solution to our problem in Newton's book. In definition 3, he defines something called materiae vis incita, or matter's innate force, as an object's ability to resist changes in motion. That is inertia. Newton thought of inertia as a type of force, and to distinguish it from other forces, he called the rest vis impressa, or impressed forces. Then, over the course of a few hundred years, these terms evolved, as tongues doth commonly do. Innate force became inertia, and impressed force shortened to just force. And this is what was taught to physics students. Inertia was not a force, it was something special. Fast forward to Einstein and Hilbert, who discover gravity is just another form of inertia, and suddenly gravity can't be a force, because inertia isn't a force. So are you saying physics just needs to go back to an older definition? That is exactly what I'm saying. While dictionaries are not the final authority on language, neither is modern physics. If defining force the way Newton did brings physics more in line with how current-day people use the word, that seems like a no-brainer to me. So as a science communicator, I'm going to fight my inertia and change my language. Gravity, in any context, is an influence between objects. It may be indirect in this newfangled space-time thing, but that nuance does not matter in the common use of the word. Gravity is a force. And until next time, remember, it's okay to be a little crazy. The Maffa Gaffo said, "Do division, you coward." JK, we can't possibly expect a 10-minute video to include division operations. Yeah, there's a reason I left it out. It would have been a little too advanced. Anyway, thanks for watching.
Okay.
Whatever you need, Leo gets.